The system menu provides a list of the modules available. Now, besides the core modules, which are general ledger, accounting reports, accounts receivable and payroll, project management, there are four additional modules, and that's equipment management, which is for users looking to manage costs, depreciation, billable rates, and allocation of equipment assets, estimating and scheduling, service receivables for companies who have a service element to their business, and inventory. Now, the user interface and navigation is a key component of Sage 100 Contractor. Sage has worked really hard to make the interface user-friendly and flexible. These activity centers organize data entry and reporting tools into logical workflows and organized resources. Additionally, each user can control which activity centers they see when they log in and how each work center looks, adding, removing, or rearranging icons. This feature is really helpful to new users and users who may be new to working with a database. They're able to organize their workflow and see only the icons and system resources that they need. Now, the dashboard is another tool that's available to each user. Based on their security settings, they can add and remove content from the general ledger, payables, receivables, and projects. Also, important reports can be run on a regular basis with the results emailed to yourself, to others, and even other people that are not using Sage, other members of your team that may not be working on a computer. This can be a great tool in keeping your team organized and on the same page. Sage 100 Contractor offers a workflow model that starts with estimating and continues through to project management. Estimate or takeoff details can then be exported. They can be exported to the budget or proposal, and then details that are associated with vendors and subcontractors, those can be converted to RFPs, purchase orders, and subcontracts. Users can return to the estimating tool during the project and use the features to create detailed change orders and service work orders. Now, once this information is exported, it becomes a part of project management and accounting. Now you can manage committed costs like subcontracts, change orders, and purchase orders. We'll look at the change order screen. Within the change order screen, you can enter, track, and manage your client change order. So you have the ability to track the status of the order, various submission and approval dates, and the requested amount versus the approved amount. Additionally, you'll be able to enter budget adjustments and subcontract change orders related to the client change order. You can see here two subcontract change orders issued for this one owner change order. You can also control the status of the subcontract change order and the date approved. Now, job cost reports are available that provide both summarized snapshots of the project, like this job status report, a simple summary of the job is provided with contract values and invoices above and project budget and costs below, a committed cost report, summarizes the data by cost code. Costs to date are shown here, and then outstanding subcontracts, purchase orders are shown here, followed by labor hours for the current payroll period that have not yet been processed. Reports offer drill-down capability, and this allows you to investigate report details, drilling down all the way to the point of entry. I'll drill down on this purchase order value. Then into the value again, I see a list of all purchase orders that make up this value. I can even drill down farther, all the way to the original purchase order entry. So these are some examples of summarized reports, but as I mentioned, detailed reports are also offered. Within the project management job reports menu, there are 96 reports provided. As I mentioned, the project details also filter into accounting. Budget or proposal figures can be used to generate AIA formatted progress billings. I'll show you an example of one of the billing formats available. Here's your cover page, followed by your schedule of values. Now, committed costs are also available in accounts payable. When entering invoices, users can reference either a purchase order or subcontract. When they do so, the details of the commitment fill in the invoice screen, and only available funds or quantities to bill are visible. Stage 100 Contractor allows users to navigate to other locations without closing the screen they're currently in. For example, from this screen, I can look at the vendor file, review vendor details like subcontracts, purchase orders, invoices, and payments, then return to my invoice entry screen. The hot list is another feature that allows your team to stay connected. Invoices, costs, commitments, proposals, progress billings, and project documents can be added to the hot list. The hot list appears in the Project Work Center and Project Hot List screens. Now from here, a user can, on a job-by-job basis, review all transactions that have been marked for their attention. Once within the record, the user can view and add notes, view and add record attachments, and even change the status of the record. Once they're complete with their review, they can uncheck the hot list button and then remove the item from the Project Work Center. Sage 100 Contractor is also a full-service payroll platform. Whether you manage payroll in-house or use a third party to process payroll, Sage 100 Contractor can accommodate your workflow. Workers' compensation, prevailing wage, and union payroll benefits can all be incorporated into your payroll settings. Your project management team can have access to fully burdened labor details and reports. You can develop workflows that incorporate system warnings and alerts, record status settings, the hot list, and scheduled reports to bring your team together, allowing project management efforts to be utilized by accounting, and accounting to provide real-time job costing to project management. User-defined fields and the ability to modify required fields, data formats, and user security allow you to manage how people enter data, where they enter data, and who has access to what. Review and reporting tools allow you to modify system reports and create your own custom reports. Now, some of the features we didn't review today include additional project billing features like unitary billing and T&M. We also did not review in detail any of the features available in the equipment management, scheduling, service receivable, or inventory sections. This was just a quick snapshot of the Sage 100 Contractor offers. If you'd like a more in-depth demo of the program, I can schedule something with one of our Sage 100 certified consultants.